respected teachers and principal ma'am. I am Rajiv Bhatta of class 7 boys presenting a experiment of physical science topic air pressure. I have set a water bottle and done a hole in it and set a straw inside it and taken a balloon and a rubber mat. Now I will blow the balloon. And I will fix the rubber band at the mouth of the balloon. Now I will fix the balloon at the mouth of the bottle. When it will fix, now I will loose the rubber band. Now we can see that due to air pressure, the water is coming out of the straw. When the air will finish in the balloon, the water will stop coming out of the straw. The air finished, the water coming out of the straw stop. The experiment had done successfully. Thank you and have a nice day.
Good morning ma'am, I am Daraksha Parveen from class 7 girls. Today I am going to show you two simple experiments which is based on physics. My first experiment is CO2 experiment. So here I have taken normal water. Let's see what happened when we put the burning candle towards the normal water. The candle does not extinguish because here CO2 is absent. Let's add some ENO in this normal water. The candle extinguishes because in this mixture CO2 is present, and this proves that CO2 does not support combustion.
Thank you, ma'am. My name is Tan Nadeem and I am of class 7 boys, and today's my topic is temporally magnetized nail chains. Okay, the things we need in this experiment are a magnet, 5 nail pins. Okay, now let's start the experiment. First we will take the magnet and put a nail from the box. Okay, we will attach this nail to the magnet. As we can see, the nail is attached to the magnet. We will take another nail to it. And we will not attach this nail to the magnet but to the first nail. Okay, as we can see that the second nail is temporarily attached to the first nail, and when we will put out this first nail, the second nail will also get lost his magnetized power. Okay, as we can see, the first nail has lost its magnetized power, the second nail can't attach it. So this is temporarily magnetized nails chain. Okay, so we'll make a temporarily magnetized nail chain with this magnetic power. As we can see that my magnet has attached 4 nails towards it, and when we will put out this first nail, all the 4 nails will lost its magnetized power. Okay, but it depends on the magnetic power. Okay, so when I will take this fifth nail, it can't attach to it because my magnetic power is with 4 nails. Okay, so this is called temporarily magnetized nail chains. Okay, thank you.
My name is Janvi Jaiswal. I am from class 7. I am going to do my physics experiment.
I am going to do experiment with candle. For this we need one plate, 2 glasses, 1 glass empty and 1 glass of water, and 1 candle and a max box. So first we have to light the candle. then fill the plate with the color water. And take the empty glass and cover the candle. As you can see, the water is slowly coming. As you can see, the water is slowly coming inside the glass. This happens because
fire needs oxygen to burn. We are surrounded by two types of gases, carbon dioxide and oxygen. We trap both the oxygen in the glass and fire used oxygen to burn. Now it was surrounded by carbon dioxide, so it goes off and the water rises up because of the air pressure. Air pressure is same for everything, so it spreads the water down and the water comes up because of the empty space of oxygen. That's why the water rises up and the candle stop burning.
And this is Rishika Jaiswal of class 7 girls, and today I'm going to show you my experiment of physical science, and my topic is convection of heat transfer. So let's start. So first we will take hot water in a glass. And after that we will take cold water in a glass. We will mix some paint in the hot water. Now we will keep this on the cold water. And we will put this cold water on top of this hot water. And we will slowly take out this. Now you will see that the hot water is rising up into the cold water. This happens due to the hot water's density is more than the cold water. This is known as convection of heat transfer. Hope you liked it. Thank you so much.
Everybody, my name is Aksh Patel of class 8 boys roll number 1. Today I am going to show you an experiment of air pressure. First we have to take one bottle, pipe and one balloon. And then we have to do like this. And then we leave the balloon and the pressure water comes out. And then hold this and the pressure will stop. And again we have to do, this is called air pressure.
Good morning everyone, I am starting with class 8. What is density? Density tells us to predict if something will sink or float. In this single body density experiment, we will change the density of color, different colored water so that they stay separated from each other. In this experiment, I am taking four different containers containing 3 amount of 3 spoon sugar of water solution, 2 spoon sugar of water solution, 1 spoon water solution, and 3 water solution. Now we will take a clean glass jar, I'll pour 3 spoons of water solution, take it big, then push the water center.
change it blue.
Heat is transforming. So I have, for this experiment, I have taken one iron rod, some iron nails which I have stick with the melted wax and a candle. So I have put, I will put the iron rod like this on the candle. We will wait for a while. We will observe that the first nail fell first. Thus the heat is transforming this region to another region. Like The first heat is coming upwards and heated this region, and then the heat molecules get vibrated and transform this region to another. And we wait for this nail also to fill. My three nails have fallen down like that. So four have fallen. So this is my experiment.
A very good morning to you. I am Nida Shakil of class 8, roll number 11. Today I am here to show my physical science experiment proving that graphite is a good conductor of electricity. To do this experiment, I have taken a 9 watt battery, two pencils, a switch, a bulb and some wires. First, I have connected the battery with the use of some wire, connected a switch and a bulb at the another end of the pencils. Now when I will turn on the switch, the bulb will glow. Seeing this, a question arises in our mind that how the bulb glows without being connected with a switch or wire. Seeing this, a question arises in our mind that how the bulb glows without being connected with a battery or switch. The answer to this question is that when I turn on the switch, the electricity flows through the wire to the graphite present in the pencil, and that graphite conducts electricity till the another end and makes the bulb light up. In a graphite molecule, one valence electron of each carbon atom remains free, thus making graphite a good conductor of electricity. So I have proved that graphite is a good conductor of electricity by using pencil, which is made of wood, which is bad conductor of electricity.
My name is Gurdeepak Singh. Today I am going to explain an activity based on force and pressure, and liquid exerts pressure at the same depth, means liquid exert equal pressure at the same depth. For this, we need water and an empty bottle, and make two holes at the same depth. Now I will start pouring water. So we can see that the water will flow at the same depth. Thank you.
Okay. Good morning everyone. My name is Arya Bhakta of class 8 girls. I am roll number 1, and today I am standing here to show you experiment of physical science, that's the density, about the density. So here I'm taking two glasses of the similar size, some salt, two lemons and a spoon. And I'm going to pour water in both the glasses over here. Put the glasses of water. If I put the lemon in it, it will sink down due to high density. But if I take some salt over here and I will mix it well. If you take some salt and then we mix it well, and then if we try to put the lemon in it, the lemon will not sink because the density is finished. Over here, because of high density, it sinks, but over here it doesn't sink. So this is what I wanted to tell you about the density.
Thank you. A very good morning to all of you. My name is Misha Shrimali and I am from Class 8 Girls. Today, I will be showing you a physics experiment based on heat. Heat is a form of energy that gets transferred by various methods such as conduction, convection and radiation. In fluids, heat transfer takes place by convection. Let's look at a simple activity to observe convection in action. For this experiment, we need two glasses, some colored water, a CD, hot water and cold water. Let's start the experiment. We will take hot water into one glass. Rises up as seen by the movement of the colored water. This is because hot water is less dense than the cold water, thus rises up with the fluid along with the transference of heat. This mode of transference of heat is called convection and can happen in all types of fluid. This is mainly because of movement of fluid particles. Now, if we invert the position, there is no movement of the liquid because the hot colored water is less dense than the cold water. So the cold water will not allow the hot water to sink into it. This experiment demonstrates that the convection is a mode of transference of heat and it only happens in the upward direction. Thank you.
Because the force of gravity naturally pulls down on the water. Now, I will show the experiment. This is a glass of water and
thank you. everybody, I am Satyam Gupta of class 9. Today I am going to show vacuum experiment. In this experiment, first we have to take some colored water. Then put the candle on it. Then blow the candle. Put the glass on the burning candle. And colored water rises inside the glass. Because the reason behind it, the air that is oxygen present inside the glass is used for burning the candle, and candle is put off due to lack of oxygen, and there a vacuum is formed. Fill that vacuum, the water rises inside the glass.
Hello, my name is Faiz Alam from class 9 boys. And here I am showing you the experiment of Tyndall effect. So what is Tyndall effect? Tyndall effect is the phenomenon when the colloidal particles are big enough to scatter the beam of light and makes its path visible. So now I will show you the experiment. So now I have taken two solutions. In the first glass I have taken pure water, and in the second one I have taken the mixture of Dettol and water. So now I will show you the experiment with the torch. So when I put the torch on the first glass, we cannot see any path passing through it. But when I put the torch on the second glass, which is a mixture of Dettol and water, we could see the path. It is visible to our eyes. So this shows the Tyndall effect. Thank you.
My name is Aarti Poddar and I am from class 9. My physical science topic is balloon blow up experiment. For this experiment, we need a plastic bottle, vinegar, baking soda and balloon. At first, we have to take the bottle and add the vinegar into the bottle with the use of funnel. Now we have to take the balloon and put it into the funnel. And now we have to add baking soda in the balloon by using a funnel. Now we have to put the balloon into the mouth. Now we have placed the balloon in the mouth of the bottle. Then we have to lift the balloon so that the baking soda gets into the vinegar. And you can see that the balloon will inflate.
Good morning, ma'am. I am Kashish Modi of class 9 and I am going to show the experiment of reflection of light of physical science. For this experiment, I have taken a white sheet of paper, a comb, mirror and a torch. Now I will fix this comb and mirror over white sheet, and I will fix this white sheet in the table. Now you can see I have fixed the paper in the table and I have fixed the mirror and a comb. Now I will throw a light from a torch through the opening of the comb. What do you observe? You will observe after striking the mirror, the ray of light is reflected in another direction. The light ray which strikes any surface is called the incident ray. The ray that comes back from the surface after reflection is known as reflected ray. I am going to switch off the light so that you can see the light rays clearly which are coming back from after striking the mirror. Now you can see the rays clearly. The rays which reflected the mirror is the incident ray, and the ray which come back from the mirror after strike is the incident, is the reflected ray. These all rays are the reflected rays.
Now we are going to do Eno reaction with water. So we have to put some Eno in the glass of water. And now we are going to blow the candle. So as you can see, the candle extinguished. So it means Eno provides CO2 gas which stops oxygen. So zero oxygen does not support fire. We have seen it. So now we are going to see that Eno which produce CO2 gas is effective for long time or not. Let's see. No, the candle is not extinguished. It seems Eno CO2, which is CO2, is not effective for long time. So, seen our Eno experiment. Eno is produced by Geologsmith Lime. Its main ingredients are sodium carbonate, sodium bicarbonate, and citric acid. Thank you for watching.
A generating station which converts steam energy or heat energy into electrical energy is known as steam power generator. Steam power generator simply means that the steam from the boiling water spins or rotates the turbine connected with a generator to an LED. The mechanical energy of the steam is converted to electrical energy through the generator, and which is why the bulb is glowing.
I am Srishti Verma from class 10, and today my topic for physical science project is water level indicator alarm. Simple transistor based water level indicator circuit is very useful to indicate the water levels in a tank. Here we have created levels by alarms, and we have added LEDs to indicate the level of water and one buzzer to indicate full level. When tank gets filled completely, we get beep sound from the buzzer. Now let's see the experiment. hear this beep sound of the buzzer.
I hope you all will like my physical science project. Thank you.
Hello, this is Anshika Chaudhary from Class 10. And today, my topic for physical science is experiment on electrolysis of water. Electrolysis is the decomposition of water into hydrogen and oxygen gas due to passage of electricity through them. To do this experiment, I will take some things like pure water, some salt, graphite pencil, a DC current, which is a battery, and I have a electric meter. First, I will add this salt into the water. As we know, water is a bad conductor of electricity, and to make it a good conductor, a small amount of a strong alkali or water or salt must be added into the water before electrolysis. Now, I have graphite pencil and a battery. Graphite pencil because graphite is a good conductor of electricity, and DC current because AC current changes the polarity of electrolysis. Now, first I will check the potential difference between the two electrodes. As you can see that the potential difference between my two electrodes is 7 volt. Now, I will just dip my electrode into the water. Now, hydrogen gas will appear at cathode and oxygen gas at anode. Let us see equation at cathode. At cathode, it is a reduction reaction because 2H2O, which is a liquid, accepts 2 electrons and gives us H2 gas. And anode, it is an oxidation reaction because 2OH minus aqueous solution gives us oxygen gas. So, overall reaction is 2H2O will give us 2H2 hydrogen gas plus O2 oxygen gas. So from here we know that hydrogen is twice in that of oxygen. So now let us see it closely. You can see that hydrogen gas reaction towards hydrogen gas is twice in that of oxygen. Now the gases has started to decompose. You can see the gas here. Now, let us know about the advantages of electrolysis of water. By doing electrolysis, hydrogen and oxygen gas is obtained. About 5% of the worldwide hydrogen gas is obtained from electrolysis, and oxygen gas is also obtained from electrolysis. So this was the model which I was representing. Hope you like it.
I am Shruti Gupta, studying in class 10. I had chosen the topic Can Sound Move Objects for my work craft in physical science. First, we take some rice in a ball, a bowl and speaker and play music. Then we will put some rice in over there. Now see the effect. The reason behind this is because the loud music produces noise which vibrates. That this makes the air vibrate as well, producing sound waves. When these waves hit the bowl vibrates, making the rice jump. Thank you.
My name is Alisha Jamal from class 10, and I am here to present my physics experiment, which is based on lens. Lens, the word reminds us the lens of our camera, the lens of the spectacles. There are two types of lens, concave lens and convex lens. We have been learned that the concave lens is diverging in nature and the convex lens is converging. Now we will see the reality.
This is a convex lens. We will consider this lens as a series of small reflecting prism as we see in the diagram. This is a prism together make this lens. When light enters in the prism, there is a change in the medium. Light enters from rarer medium, that is air, and to the denser medium, that is the glass. Due to this change in medium, the velocity lies change. As the result, the light bends. Now Now the bending is different in each of the piece. Now each of the pieces of the prism, that because the different shape of the prism has shape surface of prism change. The angle which the ray is incident on each this prism is also changed. As a result, different rays come out. Each of these pieces, they bend differently, and next at one point, here's the point P, that the reason we call the convex lens is converging lens, because the ray is converged at the point P. After reflection, we will experimentally see that what is the phenomenon. To show the experiment, I have taken a water and I have added some Dettol in it. This is a convex lens. I have taken two laser light to show the experiment. The two rays after reflection, they seem that they converge at a point. So we see here that the convex lens indeed to behave as a converging lens. Concave lens is thicker in between and the thinner at the edge. So the concave lens, the shape is different, but the concept will remain same. Here we also have different prism, and now we, in this case, the light get bends after reflection. The little difference at because this shape of the lens. So after reflection, all the rays are tempt away from the each other. That is why they diverge.
Smriti Prakash Sahu of class 10 presenting the physical science model. So let's go. So today I am going to do the experiment on a vacuum of a glass on a tray. So for this we just need some common products like a candle, a matchbox, a glass and a wet paper. So for this experiment we first need to put the wet paper on the tray. After putting the paper on the tray, we need the candle placed at the center of the paper. After we placed it, we have to fire it on. So you can see that it is done. After burning a little bit, we will put the glass on the candle tightly. Now the candle burns out. So now I am gonna test that how the vacuum works. So I am gonna put some weights on the tray. Now when I pick the glass, all the things come with it. So the experiment is successful. Now I am gonna explain the how it is working. When the inside air gets a contact with the candle, so the candle consumes all the air oxygen inside the glass. So the air pressure inside the glass is less than the outside air pressure. So when it happens, the difference of the pressure makes the glass and the tray hold to each other very tightly, and thus the vacuum occurs. So now we need a lot of pressure to open this. Thank you. Hope you enjoyed it.
Good morning everyone, I am Krish Gandhi of class 10 and today I am going to show you an experiment called drip drop water. So let's get to it. So as you can see, a bottle full of water is taken right over here. Inside it some safety pins are attached. So let's put them out one by one. So as you can see, there is a hole in the bottle because of this safety pins. So though the water is not coming out of the bottle, but when we open it, the water starts coming out of the bottle. Why? The reason behind this is when you cover up the lid of the bottle, the water is cooling down. But that air up in the top of the bottle is becoming a vacuum. That means low pressure. The air pressure outside the bottle is higher. So it actually rises to push into the bottle through the bottom hole. In doing so, it keeps the water in. When you release the hole on the top, there is no vacuum. So the water is free to flow out the hole in your strain. If you ever try to squeeze all the water out of a bottle, you might notice that if you hold it straight upside down and it squeezes it, doesn't all come out. Have you let the bottle fill back up with air before it starts up? Where else you have seen this phenomenon take place? Some people use canned juice or evaporated milk and have to put hole in top to empty it. Do you know what else they do? They put another hole up top to make it pour better. Why? This stops a vacuum from forming and allows the liquid to pour out.
Hello everyone, I am Ketan Thiri of class 10 boys of the Calcutta Anglo-Gujarati School, and in this video I am going to show you such experiments of the physical science project model, and one of them is reversing arrow and the another one is balloon and candle experiment. My first experiment is reversing arrow experiment. So as you can see, we have a piece of paper with an arrow drawn on it behind the glass. So when you fill the glass with the water, the arrow is getting reversed. So let me tell you why this happens. It happens because light travels from the air through the glass, through the water and through the back of the glass, and then back through the air before hitting the arrow. So anytime that light passes from one material into another, it bends or refracts. So my another experiment is balloon and candle experiment. So when I am getting closer the air balloon to it, look, it burst. But if I am getting closer the water balloon to it, look, it is not bursting. Look, it is not bursting. It is not bursting. Let me tell you why it happens. It happens because the air balloon burst while the water balloon does not. This happens because water is a great conductor of heat and it does not allow the balloon to overheat. That's all.
Welcome everyone. I am Siddhant Singh of Class 10 Boys of the Calcutta Anglo-Gujarati School. Is now going to show you two experiments. One on the separation of water and oil, and the other one is on why a balloon doesn't burst when pressing on the beds of clay. Let's have a look.
Here I have taken half glass of water and half glass of oil. Now I am going to pour the water into the oil and let's see what happens. Now I am going to pour the water into the oil and the oil will stay separate from the water. Because water is held together by the hydrogen bonds, oils and fats are not have any polar part to dissolve in water. They would have to break some of the water hydrogen bonds. Water will not do this, so the oil is formed to stay separate from the water. As you can see, the layer is formed. The oil is in the upper portion and the water is in the lower portion. It is formed. Here I have taken one nail and taking one balloon and will press against the nail and let's see what happens. Touch the balloon, and now I am going to replace the one nail from the beds of nail and doing the same process with the balloon and pressing the balloon against the nails, and let's see, the balloon doesn't burst because we know that the pressure equals to force per area square. In the first case, the area was very small, thus the pressure was more. And in the second case, the area was more and the pressure was less, thus the balloon doesn't burst. This is the science behind this. Thank you.
My name is Kishan Dolagia from class 10 boys. Today I will show you density experiment. First take a 2 glass with common tap water and then take 1 lemon and put it into the water. Now we can see that lemon sinks in the water. And on the other end, take 1 tablespoon salt and add to the water. Stir it well while water salt soluble is ready. And then take another lemon and put it into the water. And we can see that the lemon floats. Why? Because the lemon density is less than water density. On the other, the density of lemon is higher, so it sinks. This experiment shows that an object has less density than water floats in it, while the density of other object which is higher than the water sinks in it. Thank you.
Hello everyone, my name is Deepak Sharma and I am from class 10, and today I am here to show you the model of physical science, and the topic is popping a balloon with an orange pill.
Without wasting any time, let's jump into the topic. For this experiment, we required an orange pill and a balloon. So let's start the experiment. Now let's start the explanation. It is very well known by chemists that nonpolar substances dissolve well in other nonpolar substances. We like to say that like dissolves like. Therefore, when the lemon in oil contacts the surface of a balloon, some of the rubber balloon dissolves in the lemon. This weakens the balloon, causing it to pop. Because lemon is a hydrocarbon and hydrocarbons are nonpolar molecule, one would expect lemon to be nonpolar. So what does all this chemical information have to do with balloons popping? When squirted with orange peel juice, well, balloons are made primarily of rubber like lemon. Rubber is a hydrocarbon and it's nonpolar as well. I hope you like the experiment. Thanking you.